Hi guys, what's up? So today I'm going to talk about financial markets. By the way, welcome to the series of financial markets. Today I want to bring this point, but in a different way, by the way. So as far as financial markets are concerned, we can kind of, you know, bifurcate that into two segments. One is the international market. So we have international market, and another we can say that domestic market. Okay, so here we can talk about the Indian financial market and the international financial market. Now, before we go ahead, let's try and understand the landscape of this topic, by the way. So, it has some merits, no doubt. It also have some demerits, by the way. There are a bunch of people who would say that financial markets have done phenomenally well over a period of time, and it has given some benefits to the public, to the household, to the investors, by the way. And some people will say that, you know, it has done a great damage to the world. So it has its own pros and it has its own cons, by the way. Now, what I want you to guys understand is, like, let's look at this thing from a different perspective altogether, because there's one thing which is very much sure, that financial markets helps very well for your economic growth. So any country cannot sustain without financial markets, by the way. It has to have financial markets to kind of, you know, grow and compete with the other countries globally. Now, as far as international markets are concerned, though we have bifurcated them international and domestic, let's try and understand some common factors or some common characteristics of a financial market, some common functions or some common points, good points that helps the entire world economy, by the way. Now, the first thing that I want to say is financial markets do a fantastic job in bringing certain stakeholders. Now, when I say stakeholders, what I mean to say here, there are lot many stakeholders, to be very honest, but predominantly it brings together these three stakeholders or these three segments, you would say. So the first thing that I want to say is the business, then it brings together government and household. Yes. So financial markets helps us to kind of, you know, bring these three together. Now, how it works, why it's important, I'll be talking about this in a while. Now let's move on to the another point. How financial markets helps us in the other way. The other way is called as price discovery. Okay. Price discovery is basically, see, for example, if you're an investor, okay, and if you want to invest money in say any market. So what you want to do is basically you want to buy an asset. Okay, if you want to buy an asset. And you're not really sure how much you should be paying for this asset, how much should be paid for it. Now, how it works is, basically, in financial markets, the price of an asset is decided by or is done by the forces of demand, okay, and forces of supply. So, if you have studied law of demand and law of supply, you would understand this. So, basically, what happens here, the demand and supply would decide the prices for an asset or for a security. For a security. So it's basically in an economic term, it meets the equilibrium, which would be a price. So the price cannot be decided by an individual. And that is the reason the price discovered or the price designed by the forces of demand and supply in the financial market is pretty genuine. Okay. And is something that investors believe in. Okay, so this is the fantastic function that financial market does, is that it discovers the price on its own with the help of forces of demand and supply. Okay, now let's move ahead. Let's try and understand, does this happen all the time? This is one aspect of your financial market. Now, there is another aspect also, which is called as the OTC market, which is over-the-counter market. Now, in case of over-the-counter market, which is definitely a part of financial market on a wider term, I would say, in OTC, the prices are decided by individuals, or to put it in a nice way, parties to the trade or contract. Okay. So that's how the price is decided, by the way. Now, the price is decided on mutual understanding between the parties to the contract or trade. This is basically to do with the derivatives. I will be talking about derivatives in a different video altogether. So, you have one side wherein the prices are decided by the economical perspective, and you have the other side where the prices are decided by the parties itself. Okay. Now, so you get best of both the world. So if you want to get into a transaction, or you want to get into a derivative contract where if the product is OTC, you can definitely, you know, bet, quote, negotiate the price. So you have both the sides in the financial market. Rather, you have the advantage given by the financial market, and you can enjoy that, certainly. Okay, let's move on to the another point. So the point third here is basically liquidity. Now, this is something we can discuss in detail manner. Liquidity is quite important. Now, what kind of liquidity I'm talking about? Now, let's go back to the basics. So you have household. Okay, now say there is Mr. A. Okay, so we have a person out here. So he is Mr. A. Okay, now what he wants to do is basically say Mr. A has, say, around about, you know, $1,000 with him. Okay, he's got $1,000 with him. Now, instead of putting this cash idle in the house, what he does is he decides to invest it somewhere. Okay, but the problem is that where to invest that? That's what he's thinking about. Where to invest that? He also wants to invest this in a security which is more legitimate and which has a price. Now, as we know that financial markets, the price is discovered by the forces of demand and supply. He says that, okay, fine, I will be more than happy to invest this money, this $1,000 out here, in one of the financial instrument or in one of the financial security, we can call it as. Okay, and he invests in, say, some bonds or say some shares of some companies or something like that. Okay, so he does that. What happens is the money gets back, rather the money gets to the company. So household invests money into the financial market. Okay, the government or the private companies or the businesses can definitely get benefit of this money and can be utilized for its working capital or can be utilized for its business expansion, or we can say business diversification. So the household money, rather than being idle in the house, gets into the market wherein they have a buyer or a seller. Both the side you can check. So basically, somebody who is a saver can become a investor or can meet an investor. So financial market is a place where a saver and an investor can come together and do a business or do a trade. Now, this is the one side of the matter, that if the business requires money, there are a lot of investors in the market, the individual investors or the corporate investors, they can put the money into the market and the money gets available to the other side of the party. Now, on the other hand side, say for example, the same guy, Mr. A, now he needs his $1,000 back, say because he wants to do some education or he wants to spend money on some, like, we don't know really. So say he wants that money back now, okay, for whatever reason maybe. What can he do? He can definitely go to the market, he can sell that security, and he can get his money back. So say for example, he invested that money for 1 year, say at a rate of, say, 7%. So what happens at the end of the day, he gets his principal amount back, okay, plus he gets additional earning, which is the interest. So he gets the total money, which is definitely more than what he invested a year back. And that's how financial markets can bring in the liquidity, which is most important factor to run an economy. So the best thing that financial markets would do is that give you a chance means a chance for a company or a chance for household investor to kind of bring the liquidity. So you can buy the shares, you can buy the security, you can buy the bond, you can sell them anytime. So there are certainly securities which comes with lock-in period and all that. I'm not really talking about it, but yeah, if I keep these things a little aside, you know, if I don't really look into the lock-in period, you can buy or you can sell the securities at any point in time, you can make the money out of it, and that's how you can bring in the liquidity for both the parties, for the saver also and for the investor also. So that's the great job, or that's the main role I would say that the financial markets are doing currently by giving you guys a liquidity. Number four is a little bit interesting. I think, okay, so let me put it in this way. Number four would be reduction in transaction cost, or rather it reduces the transaction cost. Now, this is a little technical. So see, for example, if somebody wants to invest certain amount of money somewhere, right? Rather than doing a lot of research, rather than doing a lot of hunt on its own, rather than paying to the brokers or rather than paying to the middlemen, financial markets have given us the ability and the liberty that we can directly put that money into the international market, or directly we can put that money into the domestic market. So you don't really have to incur any additional cost to make your investment happen. You can really do it on your own. Yeah. The disclaimer is there are certain hidden costs which are available. I'm only looking at it from a you know, bird's eye view. It's a plain vanilla example that I want to give you. I really don't want to get into a lot of details, by the way. So it's a market which will reduce your transaction cost so that the more money gets invested into the market so that you get back the more out of money. That's it. So the cost gets reduced, by the way. The second point that I want to talk about is the uncertainty. Now, it has two ways. You can look at it from a different perspective, or you can look at it from a two perspective. Number one is you can get benefit, or you can make money out of uncertainty. Okay. So say you are uncertain about certain things, like you're not sure, you know, how the market is going to swing in, or, you know, how the market is going to perform. And there is always uncertainty attached to your cash flow, or uncertainty attached to your fund, I would say. Now, let me set an example of derivative. So in case of derivative market, you can actually get into a contract, or you can actually get into a trade where you can get benefit out of this uncertainty. So maybe there are two parties. One is long perspective. One is with the long perspective. So that person goes long on one of the securities. So the underlying security is common, by the way. And the other guy goes short on it. Now here, both the guys are uncertain. So one feels that, okay, the price of this equity share can move the ladder up in, say, 6 months down the line. And the another guy, so A has the long perspective, B has the short perspective. So B believes that, or he feels that, or he anticipates that the price of this share will reduce in next 6 months. So both of these guys are uncertain, but what's happening? They're getting into a contract and they're making money out of it. So at the end of the 6 months contract, one person will be losing the money and one person will be making money out of it. So this is a great platform given by financial markets to make money out of uncertainty. Now that's point number one. Now if you look at it from a different perspective, which is nothing but an insurance industry. Okay. Now insurance industry works predominantly on the uncertainty factor. Okay. So say, you don't know what's gonna be there, you know, next day or like, you know, a year round the line. Yeah. So what do you do? If you want to get secured by certain uncertainty, you can pay a premium. Okay. You can pay premium to insurance companies and you can get yourself covered by the uncertainties. Now what happens is that whenever the event occurs, now you know there are certain things which are uncertain. It can be anything. It can be a catastrophic thing, or it can be a natural thing, by the way. So when you know that when the event occurs, you have somebody who can compensate you for the amount of money that you have given to that institution. So financial institution is a part of financial market, which we will be talking about in this next session, by the way. So financial markets help you to kind of, you know, get secured or kind of mitigate the risk which you have. Now here I want to quote something called as ceteris paribus. Okay, this is basically an economic term, means other things being equal, a person will always love to invest money into something which is less risky. So ceteris paribus, financial markets will give you an exposure to kind of make money or enjoy the uncertainty or kind of secure the uncertainty. Definitely you cannot really secure it by 100%, but up to certain extent you can definitely do that. Okay, so uncertainty, we discussed about the insurance market and the derivative market. Now after considering these things, right, the point number six would be because of the savings that gets into the market, which helps the companies, the businesses, the organizations to kind of, you know, help to have that cash flow. And again, the person who is investing money into the market gets money back with certain amount of surplus, which is nothing but the interest. If you consider all these points together, what helps is the financial markets actually helps to to bring in the economic growth of that nation. So though there are certain disadvantages of economic disadvantages to financial markets, which is 1929 or maybe 2008 crisis and all that, but if you look at in the long term, the benefits are quite higher. So if I look at financial markets, it's not only the point that, you know, that I would say that it's not only benefiting to the clients, but I think on the other side, it also helps everybody to make money out of it. And again, to be very honest, it's up to a person that, you know, how he wants to make uses of financial markets. But trust me, I think this is one of the best thing to have your nation grow and people of nation to grow, to be very honest. Now, in the coming series of this financial markets, I will be talking about the types of financial markets, which is predominantly capital market, money market, derivative market, third and the fourth market, by the way. Then we'll be talking about the financial instruments, and then we'll be talking about a couple of financial institutions, the rules and the regulations. Okay. Now, I hope you like this video. I would request, if you like this video, subscribe to the channel Ketan KG and enjoy same amount of videos in future. Thank you so much, guys, listening to me. Thank you so much.